Hello everybody, greetings to you all and welcome. In previous video, I have started discussing the chapter We Are Not Afraid to Die If We Can All Be Together from Hornbill. This is the concluding video. This video is the concluding video for this chapter. Here, I am going to talk about the analytical part and literary devices, etc. By now, you know the story. See, we read stories, books, different kinds of stories we enjoy. This is one part. On the contrary, you have to prepare yourselves for exams as well. That's why we have to go through analyzing the story to make you prepare for exams. Otherwise, I believe stories, poems, novels, etc. are made to, you know, we just go through, read and we enjoy, we appreciate. That's our purpose. But here, in addition to that, you have to prepare yourselves for the exam as well. Now, so what have you gathered from this lesson? In this lesson, there are several things we cannot miss but notice. These are preparation for this dream but adventurous journey. Next is their struggle. And last but not the least, the most important part is children's behavior and their contribution. Let me discuss these at length now. Preparation. The narrator prepared himself and others accompanying him in this voyage very well. First, they built the Wavewalker, their ship. It was built professionally. They even spent months of testing it in the roughest weather they could find. Next, he took two crewmen to help him tackle one of the world's roughest seas, that is Southern Indian Ocean. Moreover, before starting this voyage, they had honed their seafaring skills. They practiced, developed, improved their skills, what they needed to set sail before they took up this type of risky and adventurous expedition. Lastly, he arranged all provisions meticulously to combat this ordeal and hazardous situation at the sea. So you people have got to know how he has prepared for this expedition. Now, next point, what we see here, you know, the way they have struggled in this story. During this risky expedition, they came across disastrous and dangerous situation, ordeals, and they faced strong gales, gigantic waves, violent tempest. Due to all these, their ship almost got near capsizing. Wavewalker was damaged tremendously from first to last. They continued their battle against the sea and the atrocious weather. On January 2 at dawn, few measures they took up to fight against enormous waves. The narrator first slowed down the boat. For this, they had to drop the storm jib, slashed heavy mooring rope in a loop across the stern. Then they double lashed everything, went through life raft drill, attached lifelines, donned oil skins and life jackets. The narrator got badly wounded. The waves tossed him around the deck like a rag doll. His left rib cracked. His mouth was full of blood and broken teeth. The deck and other parts of the ship also were full of water. Suddenly, the front hatch door was thrown open, his wife Mary appeared, screamed. She said that they were sinking. The decks were smashed and they were full of water. On the contrary, the two crewmen continuously were pumping the water out. The narrator somehow managed to stretch canvas and secure waterproof hatch covers across the gaping holes. Despite of it, some water still continued to stream below. Since Larry and Herb were trying to pump out water from the ship, more problem, arose when hand pumps started to block up with the debris floating around the cabins. Their electric pump also got short-circuited. That resulted in rise in water level. The captain found one spare electric pump and only that was working. That pump was working. Frantically, they were sending mayday calls which went unanswered. They received no response. Sue had severe head injury and deep cuts in her arm, but nobody had even time to take care of all those at that point of time. Even she ignored her injuries. They were searching for Isle Amsterdam, a very small island, so that they could take refuge over there. After 2 days, when they were first hit by that stormy sea, after 2 days, they could take their meal. That was also was a short respite. After that short respite on January 4 at 4 p.m., the situation got once again desperate. This time also, they fought against it and with courage. Ultimately, they were able to find the island and take shelter in it. They found this rocky island with very little vegetation and only 28 inhabitants in it, and felt this island was the most beautiful island ever in this world. Their survival was the result of their extreme courage, determination, tremendous physical and mental tenacity, forbearance, unmatched seafaring skill, patience, optimism, constant and incessant effort, perseverance, and attitude to never giving up. Now, when we have spotted so many qualities in them, the readers get delighted, we get delighted and feel touched by one another thing, and that is children's behavior. Time to talk about their contribution, children's contribution to the struggle, and how they also behaved or tackled these ordeals at the sea. Adults, the narrator, his wife, two crew members, their reaction was befitting their age. They fought bravely to defeat the stormy sea. But we are surprised to see how 6 and 7 years old children also bravely contributed to the struggle for their survival. Their behavior was quite unusual and different from that of how the children of their age usually behave. Instead of getting panicky, they kept cool, calm, remained composed, else they tried to motivate, energize their parents in their struggle. Children's sensible behavior shows their proactive approach to fight for survival. Their words and actions actually boosted the adult's mental strength. Sue was severely injured, you people know. In spite of that, she didn't want to worry her parents, because she realized very well that her parents were trying to save the ship. She didn't want to disturb them. Sue made a card with a few motivating words inside and gifted this to her parents. She thanked her parents. This certainly encouraged her parents to double their determination against the war with waters. On the other hand, 6-year-old Jonathan was not at all afraid to die. He told his father that he was not afraid to die if all of them could be together. What unmatched maturity at that tender age, strength of unity and togetherness. This was surely the children, this was the way surely we can see the children, they devoted themselves in this struggle and contributed immensely to defeat the atrocious sea. We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. What could be more befitting title for this story than this, you tell me? Very apt. So this is all about the analytical part of the lesson. You have got to know what they have done in their preparation for this expedition, how they have struggled, and you have seen the behavior of the adults and the children as well. Let's move on to the discussion of figures of speech. Dear learners, whatever the literary devices I am going to discuss now, the definitions of all those were, all these or those whatever were discussed in my previous videos, please refer to those videos in respect of the definitions. Here I will cite examples and name the devices. First, to start with, now this one, endless enormous seas rolling towards us. This is an example of alliteration. Here sound S is repeated, and you know sound S most of the times we have seen refers to harsh reality and adversity. Okay, next one is this page we have water, water everywhere. Repetition, water, the word is repeated over here. Repetition is one literary device. Next is subsequent waves tossed me around the deck like a rag doll. Simile, like a rag doll. Narrator is comparing himself to a rag doll. That means he was tossed around the deck like a rag doll. Now next one, the last one we have is, you know, there as big as a battleship. One another example of simile. The island is only as big as a battleship. Isle Amsterdam is compared here to a battleship. So by the way, do you know what does the word battleship mean? Battleship is a large armored warship. Okay, so that's all about figures of speech. Time to discuss a few questions now. Let me take this question and discuss. Okay, how does the story suggest that optimism helps to endure the direst stress? I'll give you value points only. Students, based on these value points, you please frame your own answer. Now, this is a story of a fight between man and nature. First one. Second point, the nature with strong gales, gigantic waves, stormy sea was so devastating, but men also fought with all their courage and confidence. Third point, they never lost hope, never gave up their fighting. Next point, in a befitting way, both adults and children walked bravely in a positive frame of mind to defeat the stormy sea. Even they ignored their severe injuries. You know, she ignored her injuries as well. Next point, they had faith upon themselves, faith upon their unity. Together they were fearless. Last point. Their incessant struggle marks forbearance and optimistic approach in them. Dear student, this particular question will carry, this is subjective, you know, question, high thinking order type of question, and this will carry 5 or 6 marks. Now in revised, you know, that means syllabus in question paper pattern, you have subjective questions which will carry 5 marks. Okay, next take me this question, you know, comment on the title, justify the title or comment on the title, and what is the message, you know, is conveyed, that means what does the story convey, the message, or what do we learn from this story. Value points are, first I am discussing about title. In title, what are the words there? We are not afraid to die if we can all be together. These words actually were spoken by Joe, Nata's 6-year-old son. His words were followed by his actions duly. Second point. Third point, even though at a certain point of time, when Captain felt his approaching death, he and his wife felt their end was near, they refused to accept defeat. Instead, they fought together. Next point. On the other hand, children always boosted their parents' mental strength, motivated them, encouraged them. All of them, they could realize the strength of togetherness. You know, the adage, united we stand, divided we fall, truly displayed through their actions and behavior. Being together with each other made them fearless even at the verge of death. This title is an illustrious example of man's courage and optimistic approach. Now, what can we learn? What message does the story convey to us? The lesson we get to learn from this story is, though success is very rare and very tough to achieve, but it can be achieved, attained through sheer courage, determination, patience, perseverance, and optimism. We must be composed and control our senses, our faculties. We should never panic even in the face of insurmountable ordeals and obstacles. So these are the value points you are going to include to frame answers to these two questions. That's all, my dear learners. Now let me assign you with few questions. This question I take mention here. Okay, what did the captain do to protect when the rough weather began? First one. Second one, describe the ships in the narration of these events as indicated in the 3 sections of the text. Question 3. Working with words. 3 words I mention and find the difference. The words are airship, flagship, and lightship. You consult dictionary or search on the net and get it done. So that's all from this chapter. I will meet you in my next video to discuss a new lesson. So stay safe, stay secure. Bye.